I've got so many questions about compiling Geant4 on the M1 chip. I could not answer them for sure, as I did not try it out by myself. Recently, I've got a MacBook Air with an M2 chip. Time to try it out by myself. I decided to record faithfully the whole process, including going back and forth when there are problems. The story in this video may not be as linear as my other tutorials, but hopefully it demonstrates my way to identify and solve problems in the compilation process. As this is a brand new Mac, I need to install Homebrew, a software package manager for Mac or Linux, to install programs that are needed by Geant4. So I copied this one line of code from the Homebrew homepage and pasted in my terminal and ran it. Homebrew will install the command line tools for Xcode, which is roughly the Mac equivalent of Visual Studio in Windows. At the end of the installation, Homebrew asked me to run two commands: to add Homebrew to my path, which is an environment variable that is used by the operating system to find programs. So I just follow the instruction and then copy and paste the two commands in my terminal. And indeed, after that, the command brew was available in my terminal. I could run brew help to list its usage. I found it useful to read output of a command carefully. It helped me move forward easily. Now I could use brew install to install CMake and Qt version 5. CMake is needed to compile Geant4, and Qt version 5 provides a nice graphic user interface for Geant4. Homebrew will automatically install other programs that are needed by Qt or CMake. This demonstrates how convenient a software package manager is. In the end of the installation, Homebrew showed me where Qt 5 was installed, and we need this information later. Now it's time to download Geant4 from its download page in the Linux tar format. Once the downloading was done, I clicked the file in my web browser to extract files from this tar.gz file, and everything was automatically placed in my download folder. I cd into the downloads folder in my terminal and use ls to list files in it. I could see the .tar.gz file and the Geant4 folder extracted from it. I then cd into the extracted folder and use mkdir to create a folder called build and cd into it and run ccmake space dot dot and then return to start the configuration of the Geant4 compilation system. Ccmake is a command line user interface of CMake. Its usage is printed near the bottom of the terminal. Press C to start the configuration. When the configuration was done, I pressed E to quit this lock screen. I used my up and down keys to move my cursor to options that I wanted to modify. At first, I turned on Geant4 install data to let the compilation process to install Geant4 datasets automatically. I then turn on Geant4 use Qt to enable the Qt-based graphic user interface for Geant4. Press C to configure again. Now I got error messages saying that CMake cannot find the Qt libraries by itself. Press E to quit from this log message, and then Q to quit from CCMake back to my terminal, where I run CCMake again, but with an option called CMake prefix path, to which I passed the location of Qt version 5. Don't forget about the last dot dot, representing the parent directory where Geant4 source code is located. Hit enter to run it again. Now CMake complained that xQuartz GL was missing. xQuartz provides an X-Window server for Qt to run on top of it. We need to install it. So I got xQuartz from its homepage, and then clicked on the downloaded package to launch the install window and followed the on-screen instructions, which was straightforward. After that, I ran CCMake with a long argument again. Now there's no error message anymore. The output of the configuration ensured me that Qt was enabled. I ran configuration again until the generate option showed up. I then pressed G to run it. CCMake finished its task and automatically closed itself. I was back in my terminal, where I then typed make -j4 to compile using 4 cores of my 8 core CPU. Leave some cores to take care of other tasks in your Mac. Otherwise, the compilation process may crash your Mac. The compilation failed at 80%. I already spent about 24 minutes on it. That's very annoying. I scrolled back in my terminal to find out what went wrong and found that the automatic dataset downloading went wrong. That's not a big deal, as I can always install those datasets manually. So I ran CCMake again to turn off the option Geant4 install data, and ran configure and generate again. This time, I put another command called time in front of the make command to find out how long it takes to run the make command. The compilation finished successfully within 7 minutes. So in total, it took the M2 about half an hour to compile Geant4, which is roughly about twice faster than my 2015 Mac Pro running i5 CPU. Now it's time to install the compiled Geant4 libraries to my Mac with the command make install. There was some error message saying that the administrative privilege was needed to install files to the user local directory. Oh yes, I forgot to put the sudo command in front of the make install to use my administrative privilege. Of course, this time my password was needed to prove that I was indeed the administrator of my own Mac. This time, the installation ended without any error. Now I could run geant4-config-help to verify my Geant4 installation. And yes, Qt was enabled. It is nice that one of the options can be used to install datasets. So I just follow the instruction to run this command. The command failed because, again, I forgot to run it with sudo. With sudo, the downloading process started successfully. After the installation of the Geant4 datasets, I cd into the user local bin directory and source geant4.sh file in that folder. And that file is used to declare environment variables for the operating system to find Geant4 datasets. Now it's time to install my own Geant4 application, Gears. To verify the installed Geant4, I could directly download the zip file, but I prefer to use Git to download it. So I copied this URL and ran git colon URL to download Gears. CD into it, make the build directory, CD into it, and ran ccmake dot dot. Everything looked fine to me, so I ran configure, and then generate, and then make. Everything went smoothly without any error. I then cd back into the parent directory and the listed files in it. Indeed, the executable Gears was already created. I ran it with dot slash in front of it, which means the current directory. Ta-da! The cute GUI popped up in no time. Here are some takeaway messages. First, the compilation of Geant4 on an Apple chip is not different from that on an Intel CPU. So if you have an M1 or M2, feel free to install Geant4. Secondly, reading output and error messages carefully during the process really helps with solving problems encountered in the process. And third, don't forget about sudo command when you try to install something in the user local directory. And last not least, don't forget about adding the following two lines in your .zshellrc file in your home directory. The first line is used to declare Geant4 related environment variables. And the second one is used to add the location of Gears executable into your path environment variable. With these two lines of code, you can run Gears directly in any newly opened terminal.